filled with meaning and purpose. Our greatest joy is in helping others along the way. Wherever you are on your journey, we believe that we have something to offer that can make your life more whole. So the next time you see a Seventh-day Adventist, remember, you're not looking at someone who stands alone. They are connected to a world church that has 18 million members gathered in 13 divisions, comprised of 122 unions, formed by 600 conferences, serving in 140,000 congregations in 208 countries, who worship in 924 languages, and they all want to connect with you.
Changing lives.
Welcome back. Good evening and hi. This is the program Wounds of the Heart, a program where we're going to heal the wounds of the heart, being psychological, emotional, social issue, or whatever. We are here to help you heal that wounds of your heart. Tonight and this evening, we're going to discuss a beautiful topic that has kept a lot of people in the silence or in the secrets, because we still don't understand whether this topic is probably spiritual or psychological. So this evening, my guest is already seated. You saw her on the flyer. She said that those of us who couldn't get the chance to look at the flyer, very soon you're going to see her. She has been here severally, and today she's here with me to help us understand what the topic. And as usual, if you want to join us, the program is our social handle, media handle. That's on WhatsApp, is 0559-680066, 0559-680066. Facebook Live, Hope TVGH. If you want to send your comment or anything, please kindly put it there. We'll have time to read them for you. And we are still live on YouTube too. It's Hope TVGH YouTube. You can subscribe and share, so that click on notification button, so that every program you get the chance to watch it wherever you are. And in case you are outside home and you want a friend to watch, you can share on your page, or you can call a friend. But if he or she is at home, let her sit down behind the box and watch. It's Hope Channel. And we are there. As usual, Slicker Freak fabric, Slicker Freak as usual. And if you, in case you need any fabric, please don't rush the market. Just sit at home, stay there. Call 0557-355-852. Select any fabric you want, and they will just bring you at your doorstep. The name is Slicker Freak. All the time they make me look sleek. The guy who always designed my flyer, Alpha Art, God bless him wherever he is, a young, talented, and gifted guy who, it's also bilingual, it's, or conference kakra, you know, and he designed all my flyers. If in case you need any other person, whether banner, any flyer, please, the number to call is 0551-404-387, 0551-404-387, and Alpha Art will just give you the job just in the twinkle of an eye. And we want to also come to your organization, church, school, institution, wherever you want to call us to come and host the program there. The number to call is 0559-535554, and we'll come to you and we'll have the program done with you. So please, Don't hesitate to call that line. As I said, this evening we want to discuss this wonderful topic, addiction. A lot of people rush to the church, meet the pastor for prayers. My child is suffering from addiction and she needs prayer, or he needs prayer. I want us to discuss, I want us to think about it, I want us to be educated whether addiction is spiritual or psychological. So today I have with me one of the beautiful guests that I always have here in my studios to have this program with me. The name is Justina. Justina, good evening and welcome to the program.
Good evening, Rev.
And how are you doing?
Very well.
You are not a whole home on program. So today, this evening, the question I have been bothering my mind, and I want us to discern it well to the viewers up there who have been keeping this program ongoing since day one. When we talk about addiction, is it spiritual or psychological?
Thank you.
Welcome.
Yeah. Talking of addiction, I'll start by giving or describe what is it.
Okay.
Before I move to your question.
Okay.
So we'll say addiction is repeated involvement with a substance or an activity.
Okay.
So it's not just a drug. It could be an activity.
Okay.
We used to think it's only substance as in drugs.
Okay.
But activities are involved.
Okay.
So we can talk of gambling.
Okay. That is activities.
Activity. Okay. Sexual behaviors. Mm-hmm. Then we come to the drugs. Mm-hmm. The most common is the alcohol and the marijuana, cannabis, cigarettes, and so forth.
Okay.
And then eating.
So it becomes
Eating is also an activity.
Activity, okay.
Yeah.
Okay.
We're supposed to eat.
Okay.
But there's a way when you do it.
Okay.
You become addicted and it hurts you. You see, the whole thing is what you are involving yourself in, be it a substance or the activity, harm you and those around you.
Okay.
Mostly you, the one into it, might think I'm okay because you gain a gratification. You gain a level of pleasure doing that or taking that. But on the other hand, people around you are suffering because of that activity you are engaging yourself in or that substance you are using. So you bear with me that addiction doesn't affect only the person into it, but the people around him or her also suffers.
Okay.
Like in your intro, you said something like, people go to pastors that my child is into this. So you can see a mother's or a parent's struggle to get their children or their ward or their relative to join the mainstream by dropping that harmful activity. So the emphasis is on the harm it does to you and those around you.
Okay.
But come to your question, be it spiritual or not, I will not give you yes or no answer.
All right. I think that even what the question I asked are some of the myths when it comes to addiction. Do you have other myths surrounding addiction, if possible? Because addiction being spiritual, others have the prejudice that addiction is spiritual. Others also say that it's probably it is a curse or something, but I don't know.
It all boils back to spirituality.
Okay.
But that depends on your stand.
Okay.
So the question is, what is spirituality? What do we term spirituality?
Exactly.
So we can talk about years ago where spirituality was defined as a deity, that a supreme being, or the purpose of life is depend on a supreme being somewhere. So that is what probably the person believes in, that there's a purpose of life or there's not. If there is, it lies in a supreme being. On this definition, or if this is your belief, then I will say no. Addiction is not spiritual, based on this definition.
If
you believe that there's purpose for life and a meaning to life or living, but it lies in a supreme being, like gods or God or something you believe in, that is where the purpose of living lies.
Okay.
Then addiction cannot.
It's not spiritual, okay.
Yes. Okay. But in the contemporary setting or contemporary Christianity, where we are enlightened to know that God doesn't live in a special building, but that special building is you and I.
Okay.
That's my body, my being. Mm-hmm. Then you relate it to the meaning and purpose of life. So you are living as a temple of God, as a Christian, that's what I would say. But whatever you believe in, you relate it to that and it's in it. So it means that you have disconnected yourself.
Okay.
Or detach yourself from your inner being.
Okay.
Because God won't speak to my physical being here, but he will get in touch with me, with my innate being. So once you detach from that being, so in this is where addiction becomes spiritual. So you yourself, you've lost touch with reality. So that part of you that makes you reason and live a purposeful life is no more. The practical example I can give is you living with your parents in the home. Then for whatever reason you have assigned to, you leave home. Your parents are still there. They are still in the house. Probably they will look for you, but they can't find you. They'll still go back home and sleep. What about you? You have left home and you are homeless. You don't have a place to sleep. So have your parents stopped protecting you, or you have left their protection? That is addiction. If you believe it's spiritual, then you have detached yourself from that protection. That is why you are addicted, because your inner being tells you this isn't working for me, or it's creating more problems for me, but you choose to take it because of the 5 minutes pleasure. Then you have caused it. So if this is your belief, then I will say yes, it's spiritual. So in psychology, we term it as biopsychosocial spiritual model.
And what does the four model, what does it mean?
That is what I've said. It means that addiction is caused by biological factors, psychosocial, social factors, psychological factors, and then the spiritual factors.
Okay.
Based on the definition I've given with the spirituality. So it means that we need to put these four together to be able to work on addiction. But if you leave the first three and keep the last one, this is where I would say no, it's not spiritual. Because no human being is without a bone. No human being is without a cartilage. No human being is without a fluid. And this fluid are two, water and blood. Can you do without any of these?
You die, shall
you die. So if you have chosen to live with one and leave the rest, I hope you get
the link.
I just want to practicalize so that you know that
my questions are coming, so you don't have a problem.
It could be depending on your faith and your belief.
So with what you just told me, viewers, if you have questions like how I have questions to ask, you can do so on our WhatsApp platform 0559-680066, 0559-680066, or go to the Facebook page and Hope TVGH. Just send your questions there, and I'll read the questions for her to answer for all of us. Now, with the definition you gave that spirituality, it's the inner self, the instinct, what dwells within us that probably edges us as a Christian, we helps us to do the right thing, because he said we were born in his image. So we, and the body is the temple, so he dwells in us. So now spirituality is when we believe as Christians that God lives in us. Fine. So if God lives in us and we, the human being, is detached from the spirit, from God, then we can say that addiction is spiritual, because at the end of the day, I have left the protection, God's protection, and I went out from the house. So I'm not under any protection. So
anything happens,
it's me. So addiction, it begins from the person, the ability to let go from the protection that he or she was having or is having.
Yeah.
Friend, there's somebody who will say that also for, I had a dream that I was drinking alcohol. Mm-hmm. And I woke up feeling for alcohol. I went to buy it. Now I'm an alcoholic.
Okay.
I'm addicted to alcohol.
The question is, linking it to the spirituality, mm-hmm. we have dream analysis.
Mm-hmm.
So you could have find the meaning of your dream
mm-hmm.
by restricting your body mm-hmm. a little. That is where you hold on to the test for
mm-hmm.
the substance mm-hmm. or the activity.
Mm-hmm.
But because you want to pressurize yourself, make yourself feel good, this is where you have moved out of the protection.
Mm-hmm.
So I believe using parents as an example, they've told you certain things you shouldn't do. Then you said, because I saw it in the dream, mm-hmm. so I'm going to do it, knowing that your father says don't, or your parents says don't, mm-hmm. you've done it.
Mm-hmm.
It could be that in the dream, mm-hmm. you were hungry, mm-hmm. you were thirsty, mm-hmm. something.
Mm-hmm.
It could also mean that indeed somebody is pushing you there, mm-hmm. but you have a role to play.
Mm-hmm. No, we'll come back to the role that the person will play. But uh-huh. I just want us to establish the fact that you could hear a confession that somebody will say, "Me, mm-hmm. you know, I'm the one mm-hmm. I'm causing the person mm-hmm. to drink. I'm the one causing mm-hmm. the person to smoke."
You know, the devil wants fans.
Okay.
The devil always wants to take fans okay. for and then glory for whatever okay. is happening.
Okay.
So if you are a witch and you want to prove to people that, yeah, I can bewitch people, mm-hmm. wouldn't you take, even if you don't have any idea?
Oh, okay.
That's what I'm saying, that every dream has a meaning. Every thing has the positive and the negative okay. meaning. So why don't we have time and okay. find the meaning of the dream you've had?
Okay.
And again, you are who you think you are.
Mm-hmm.
You exactly. are your thought.
Yeah, definitely.
So if you are an alcoholic,
mm-hmm.
you keep telling yourself. And what, back to the inner being.
Mm-hmm.
If you communicate well,
mm-hmm.
you will hear that even at the time you were feeling for the alcohol,
mm-hmm.
there's another voice telling you, hold on,
mm-hmm.
wait, hold on,
mm-hmm.
wait.
Mm-hmm.
But because we want to take the pleasures of life,
mm-hmm.
we tend to suit the body.
Mm-hmm.
Remember I've said that an addiction is a biopsychosocial, spiritual
mm-hmm.
issue.
Exactly.
So you've dropped all the three and you are following just one. Always we have to put all the four together. Psychologically,
mm-hmm.
other issues can push you,
mm-hmm.
but it boils back to the social environment.
Mm-hmm.
Where you live, what mm-hmm. you see people do when they have, or when they are going through what you're going through.
Mm-hmm.
I'm talking about the psychological side.
Mm-hmm.
And normally they are linked together.
Mm-hmm.
Each of the four items I mentioned are linked to each other.
Mm-hmm.
So I am tired. I want to sleep.
Mm-hmm.
You've been in the vicinity. You see people taking a particular thing to mm-hmm. be able to sleep.
Mm-hmm.
So you've tend to believe that, accept that, and you are telling yourself, until I take it.
Mm-hmm.
So that voice mm-hmm. is in the brain
mm-hmm.
telling you, meanwhile, if you don't take it, nothing will happen.
That's all kind of simple. So if you don't take nothing, the person says he had a dream and that he was forced to drink alcohol. He woke up from the dream
mm-hmm.
and he's not testing for water. He's mm-hmm. not testing for anything. He's testing
mm-hmm.
for alcohol.
Mm-hmm.
And something is doing him
mm-hmm.
if he didn't take the alcohol.
Assuming the person did not know where to buy alcohol from, how
you
would
go,
it?
You run for search.
For?
You go searching for that.
And assuming in the vicinity,
I'm sure probably they will dream. They will give him a different dream altogether. So what? How is addiction? What? How is it formed? If it's not spiritual, but then, mm-hmm. if it is me, if it's mm-hmm. the person who is detached from the inner spirit,
mm-hmm.
why would that person becomes
back to biopsychosocial?
Mm-hmm.
You know, we are born with certain instincts,
mm-hmm.
genes,
mm-hmm.
traits.
Mm-hmm.
Sometimes, based on the lifestyle of your parents, mm-hmm. there's that trace
mm-hmm.
that gives you that trait,
mm-hmm.
and it's on your genes. Mm-hmm. So you can be prone to.
Mm-hmm.
Note this.
Mm-hmm.
The fact that even if it is genetic,
mm-hmm.
you are not yet there.
Okay.
you have the urge, mm-hmm. but you are not, why were you not drinking when you were a baby? Or why don't your parents give you alcohol because they dope it when you were a baby? Mm-hmm. It means that it takes certain level of development and thought, the psyche work, before you try it. And it's back to the environment and the cultural setting. So we believe that a certain group of people, this is how they are, and I am one. So I have to prove to people that I am like that. That is the sociocultural environment. You see people do it. Look at the way we adore certain adverts with certain substance on our TVs. So indirectly, we're making it enticing. And the gen factor is there. So now the brain is communicating with the body. The edge is already there, and I'm seeing it looking good. So definitely, it increases the edge. And then in the society, how do we treat those who do that? In our times, we heal them. We praise them. They are the big and the cream de la cream of the society. So indirectly, we are promoting. And you see them, those activities and then substances we get addicted to work on the brain. The dopamine level increases and you feel that high. Again, as the brain work like the reward system, you give two CDs out, you get kinky of a certain size. So if you don't want that size, you want smaller or bigger, you give multiple.
More or less.
So that is how the brain and the neurons work scientifically. So you taste one, it gives you a certain gratification. Know that before you even go in for the activity or the substance, you have something in mind.
So that's the first stage,
tasting, the trying,
the first time.
So I am feeling for it, and I see people do it. So meaning when I also do it, I'll be fine. Then you try it. And then the brain work on it. And you know, these drugs work faster. And we are different. So what will work fast on me might not do for you. If we use alcohol, the intoxication level, the quantity I will take to get intoxicated might not be same as you. And we don't know that. We can't. I can't just look at your face
and say that.
And
give
say
me the,
that.
The level, okay?
So I saw Pastor taking this bottle. Does that mean I can equally take it, or I'll be also okay with it?
Probably might be more than that or less than
exactly. that. But we don't think about those things before we start. That is where the challenge comes with.
And so every addiction begins with the testing, the trying
the
moment.
The trying moment because of our social culture setting and our psyche. You know, I said they are linked together. So as you see others do it, as growing up, you think that's okay, that is a sign of doing well. You see cigarettes, for instance, that's how it became so common. People travel outside, they come in, and they did not get the concept that their weather makes them do those things. And our weather is different. But they thought it's a sign of being in a bogam, I mean, you've been there, wet, and all those things, before they realize they are there. Some of these substances to have components that stick with the brain. So now the brain adjusts to that and cannot do certain things without it. And this is where the increment also sets in. So it starts as a habit. Because habits are different from addiction. But they work together. Addiction starts with habit. Then tolerance sets in.
No, I want us to, so at which point does it become habit? At which point does it, tolerance? So when it becomes habitual, what happens in that sense? So that in case, these things are happening to a friend of mine or somebody I know, I could quickly identify as I know where you guys are heading towards.
The habit becomes a routine, but not necessarily giving a negative impact. But the addiction brings negative effects. So you want to sleep, which is good. You take alcohol, and before you sleep, you can imagine some of the things you will do with it. insulting people you are not supposed to, mm-hmm. insult them and all those things. Mm-hmm. So it's giving you a mark. Mm-hmm. So you've moved from habit to addiction. Mm-hmm. The addictions come into the habit when the tolerance level starts increasing. Mm-hmm. So now you take one bottle and you work it. Now you yearn for more. Mm. Because the brain system has adapted. So the moment you take one bottle, you don't get the high you used to. Mm-hmm. So you need to add a little before mm-hmm. the dopamine level gets to where mm-hmm. you are expecting. Mm-hmm. Some people take drugs to work, mm-hmm. which in itself was okay. Mm-hmm. But the point is, what do you do in the mm-hmm. work? Okay, so 2 weeks, 3 weeks after, you need two of this before you can perform the same activity mm-hmm. or function that led you to taking that substance or activity. Now the body is tolerating. You get it. So this is where you've gotten out of habit mm-hmm. too.
Mm-hmm. So now, firstly, I saw it on TV, or I saw people drinking it, I saw people smoking. I read about masturbation, I read about things, and I said, okay, masturbation, some people are writing on the online that it's helpful, it's this, it's health, it reduces calories, it's whatever. So mm-hmm. I tried. Mm-hmm. The first time I tried it, I realized, no, it's really
it's cool. Mm-hmm.
That is the first trial. Mm-hmm. That moment I could stop or I could continue. Mm-hmm. So as you're saying that, from that trying moment, when I move, I escalate from the trying moment mm-hmm. to becoming a continuous thing, probably once a week or once in 2 weeks, mm-hmm. then it's becoming once a week.
And you are training the mind.
So now, that is helping me understand my spiritual or psychological, because mm-hmm. whatever we train the mind psychologically works for us.
Yes.
And you said that you are your own thought. Mm-hmm. There are a lot of people who are watching this and they feel low self-esteem because they think that they can't do anything in this world. Mm-hmm. It is what
they have accepted.
Exactly. And some people also think that they can't do anything better for themselves. Mm-hmm. So, and when you meet somebody, you said, oh, Charlie, who is cow? No, I don't have money. I don't have money.
With that attitude, yes, back to sociocultural mm-hmm, factors. Mm-hmm. We have been trained like that. We blacks are trained Ghanaians.
That you shouldn't talk about when you have Zika because you somebody say, yes. will bother you or something.
Uh-huh. And then in growing up, where mm-hmm. you find yourself, mm-hmm. this is how you see people responding or mm-hmm. reacting. Mm-hmm. So in your home, mm-hmm. people come and you have what they don't have. Mm-hmm. And for that reason, they say, oh, Miniska, it's just, you know, we try to justify mm-hmm. that we don't have money. Mm-hmm. Meaning we've accepted that mm-hmm. I can't have money. Mm. Because if you have money, what is wrong with it? Mm. If you do have, what is wrong with it? Mm. If I have and I won't give you, what is wrong with it?
See, because we're treated or something, so
uh-huh. So we don't want to own our thoughts, who we are, who we want to be. But we get confused as whether to satisfy those around us mm-hmm. or
keep it within. All right, just now I will come by. Viewers, see, I'm getting educated here about addiction, even the forms of addiction, because addiction is not probably the quote unquote spiritual thing we say. But by the end of this discussion, we will justify where addiction stands as the conversation is ongoing. The program is Wounds of the Heart. In case you just joined in, I'm going for this break. When I return, we'll continue. Stay tuned.
And Yanomani Adolphin Wayan Radi Yesumu, Chedian Ponyanko Pong, Eddie, Asasi Amaye, say Yan Yeshua Juma, Nayan Esso, Oka in Genesis chapter 2, verse 15, Yamme Juma dear Kasia, our dear Maya, Nisanti, as a sever be a tear beer near Fair Kama, near Dienya, Oman Penny President Akufuado. Ayen si se se, ese se gane yina ye green. Ezdi ye ni biya no, enta ye man penye echi. Ne se e jume diye ke siye, emraso. E free June 11. Eko yina no, ye yina no, e diye niya. Ye diye niya, and my environment, I kama. We are supposed to make Ghana green. It's so important, taking care of our environment. Everybody will have to plant a tree beginning 11th of June onwards. Make sure this becomes your project. Project belongs to every Seventh-day Adventist Ghanaian. Ye yen si se ke siyase, ya sofwo, eni ya safu mpenifwo, ebe ko disi centers, eni forestry, akwa jise eni eni na ba, ni edi ama ya safu ma, na obie dianwo ni skumu, na obie dianwo ni fie, na obie dianwo nefwom, na obie dianwo ni fie mfichire. Ye pese gane bebi arno, eye green. Awurade nsira papaapa sɛ saa dwumadie kɛse wode w'ahoɔden wonyansa ne wo sika ɛbɛta akyire ama Ghana nyinaa ayɛ green. Yɛho a ne wo ntra. Amen.
All right, welcome back from the break. The program is still Wounds of the Heart. We are discussing whether addiction is psychological or spiritual. As people say, we want to clear that prejudices that have been formed in the minds of people. So in case you just joined us, we are discussing addiction. Is it psychological or is it spiritual? And as I said, you can keep your question coming, your comment or contributions coming. Facebook Live is Hope TV GH. We are still live on Facebook. YouTube, you're live there too. So you can send your comment and we will have time to read for you. But if you want also to do that on WhatsApp, it's 0559-680066. 0559-680066. And I think that we're going to read your question for you. So we left off from where I was asking from the trying times now to continues become habitual. Is it the stage where people or addicts start being secretive? They don't want people to know. Is that stage?
Yeah, because you see that when you are trying, you might not know the harm it will do to you. Mm-hmm. But when you started noticing the harmful effect, mm-hmm. where you are not willing mm-hmm. or determined to stop. Mm-hmm. You know definitely there will be that comment. Mm-hmm. So you try to hide.
So in that stage, they don't want people to know.
Because you yourself, you know
that it's not right.
What I'm doing isn't helping me, more or less those around me, yet I want to do it. Mm. So then you try to hide it. You see that nobody is telling you hide it, but because of your psyche, mm-hmm. social culture, mm-hmm, socialization mm-hmm. have groomed you that mm-hmm. this is not done here mm-hmm. or that way. Mm-hmm. And you have decided mm-hmm. despite that. Mm. So back to the spirituality. Mm-hmm. You believe in someone mm-hmm. or you believe mm-hmm. you are with someone mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. and the person say, don't do this,
okay.
Do this.
Okay.
If you don't do this, I can't stay with you. Uh-huh. Then you have decided that what that person isn't comfortable is mm-hmm. with is what you're going to do. Mm. You know what it's likely to happen. The
exactly.
person says, whilst you do it, I pull off,
yeah.
So the moment you do it, you yourself know that person has pulled off. Mm. So your innate being, you are detached. Mm.
You don't, because you don't want the person to know you don't want
uh-huh.
it. So you don't even show it to
you
the
don't
people.
Show
so that's
it.
Where the masturbators will be locking their doors when
exactly.
they enter. That's where
and even if they are not indoors, they look left, right, back, front mm-hmm. to see if there's someone coming. Mm-hmm. If what you're doing mm-hmm. is helpful to you, mm-hmm. why can't you let others know?
I'm not getting the focus. So addiction doesn't start. You don't wake up to find yourself addicted to something.
Mm-mm.
It's a process.
It's
now.
A
so now
process.
We are at the habitual stage and mm-hmm. you are telling us that now we are doing it continuously. We are mm-hmm. doing the thing and
so
we know
repeated.
Ourselves. It's a repeated, a continuous or repeating.
Despite the harm.
The harm, okay.
And you see, the more you get, you see, the body is such that it wants comfort. Mm-hmm. So if you stick to that comfort, that's where you get destroyed. Mm-hmm. Because what you take in, or the activity you engage in, mm-hmm. in gives you gratification. Mm-hmm. But what is the end result? Mm-hmm. You mm-hmm. get it. Mm-hmm. So you get booze. You are taken to the hospital. They take care of you. You go out to work. Mm-hmm. The little that you earn, mm-hmm. you take it to the hospital. Mm-hmm. So you come back having nothing. Mm-hmm. Every week, every 2 weeks. Mm-hmm. What are you doing to yourself? Mm-hmm. Yet you still want it. Mm-hmm. That is where you are an addict. Mm-hmm.
Mm-hmm. So before we get to the addiction crowd, mm-hmm. these are the things that happen. So from habitual, where do that's a tolerance. So in that stage of tolerance, what happened?
You keep increasing the dosage or what you do.
But somebody will tell you
so
that
you do it more.
Somebody will tell you that I still have been taking the two rolls of mm-hmm. of weed since the one. I haven't mm-hmm. increased it. I haven't listened. It's two rolls.
But
two
without rolls. It, you can't be reasonable. You know, some people, before they go to the public to do something, mm-hmm. they have to be high. And whatever makes them high, why can't you go and do it without it? That is where you are. Okay. Mm-hmm. Talking about addiction, telenovelas. Mm-hmm. Some people will be in the market. Some will even get their words involved.
In watching
regarding the harm it causes mm-hmm. to, just because watch it so that when I come you tell me mm-hmm. you are introducing your addiction to that child mm-hmm. thinking because of the pleasure. You get it? Mm-hmm. Because of the pleasure. Mm-hmm. But when you so better or no, now your child has become TV addict, mm-hmm. not books. Mm-hmm. Yet you are paying school fees. So the habit doesn't give you harm, mm-hmm. but addiction...
The habit is normal. It's a normal routine of something, uh-huh. but it hasn't caused any harm yet.
That is it.
But when the tolerance comes in, when the dependency level, that's what you guys mm-hmm. call it, when the body starts depending on that drug, that
substance,
then which means that you are graduating to a level where mm-hmm. when you get there, we can't take you to the hospital.
That is where you have groomed your mind.
Okay.
To live with it, and without it, your dopamine level goes down and you can't function. So, like I said earlier, the reward system. Mm. So, if you give me garbage in, garbage mm-hmm. out, if you give me one thought, I give you one thought reaction, and that is not enough for you. So, you have to, you get it. That is where your system has tolerated the substance or the activity. So, one is now normal to the system, and that is not what gratifies you. Mm. So you top it up.
Okay. So I want my viewers to understand something, that because before somebody is known in the society or in the church or in the family to be an addict mm-hmm. of something, mm-hmm. these are the things that they go through before mm-hmm. we know. Mm-hmm. And as to how best we'll be able to know that our loved ones probably are going through something that is, it's not going to end well with them. We might not see the signs. Probably these are the, when they become secretive, as we said.
There are signs and symptoms.
Okay.
Yeah, we can talk about it.
Okay, just in a brief. So, yes. Cause so in relating to the formation of mm-hmm. of addiction mm-hmm. from trial, that there's no signs from because mm-hmm. I just tried it. It's peer pressure, or probably I was introduced
exactly.
to that. But when it becomes habitual.
Then I try to do it on my own. Mm-hmm. So you see the person withdrawn
okay.
from routine things that mm-hmm. he or she takes pleasure mm-hmm. or enjoy doing with mm-hmm. others. Mm-hmm. Now that thing no more gives him or her gratification. Mm-hmm. The person is no more interested in mm-hmm. those things. Normally they quell. They withdrawn. Mm-hmm. They want to be alone. These are signs mm-hmm. and symptoms. Mm-hmm. Either they are extremely quiet, mm-hmm. they don't eat, or they eat more than we know them to do.
So this science doesn't happen when the addiction, they get to the addiction stage, but it happens in between habitual and tolerance.
Yes.
Or dependency.
Getting to the addiction
exactly.
stage.
So the tolerance uh-huh. now for that is where family members will know that, I'm not seeing my...
The challenge I have is, We blacks only meet you and say, hello, good morning, how are you? And we are gone. I always say, and I always say that when I meet you mm-hmm. and I want to ask how are you, mm-hmm. it should be an eyeball to an eyeball. Mm-hmm. That is when I am interested in how are you. Mm-hmm. It's not a norm to say it's just like that. Because even when I'm on a dead bed, I'll still say I'm fine, thank you.
Exactly, that one everyone.
But you have to look at my nose, my eyelid, mm-hmm. my eyelashes, my eyeball movements, and you should be able to say yep. my voice. If you know Justina, she's always smiling, always in a good mood, as if I don't have problems. I do. But you meet Tina this time, and she doesn't give you that usual smile. She told you something is happening. Do we care?
Tina, but probably somebody would say that it's because of your field as a counseling psychologist. You studied human behavior, human attitude, so you could just say what you're saying now. But, for instance, a mother whose daughter just left home for secondary school mm-hmm. and Ofri Scuba, the attitude changed. Hey, now my child is in the room. Mm-hmm. She's learning. He's learning.
Is she learning?
No, it's fine. But the mom will be at the kitchen. Mm-hmm. We graduate back. She's learning. He's learning. So we mothers or parents
exactly.
wouldn't bother
exactly.
to just.
Yeah,
but
is
it?
Yeah, that so is where I want to draw
exactly.
whoever is watching us attention mm-hmm. to that. Your child may be studying, mm-hmm. but education is a mm-hmm. total development, mm-hmm. not book. Mm-hmm. So even whatever the child is studying at school should mm-hmm. let her come to the mm-hmm. kitchen and join you, because she is being trained morally as well. Mm-hmm. So she knows when to do what for mm-hmm. parents, mm-hmm. when to study. Mm-hmm. That is why you should be interested in your child's timetable. Mm-hmm. I always say from going to sleep till mm-hmm. waking yeah, up yeah. till going back to sleep. Mm-hmm. And parents should be interested. It doesn't matter whether you're educated mm-hmm. or not, you are mm-hmm. learned or not. If you don't consult others, mm-hmm. how should it be done? Mm-hmm. If I see this, what does that mean? Mm-hmm. Because lesbianism starts like that.
Mm-hmm. I was about to say that because I brought someone here and she was telling me that.
Uh-huh. Mm-hmm. You leave them all alone. I mean, your child should be your friend. Mm-hmm. That's the starting point. Mm-hmm. I saw this and a lady asked me, how can I make my mother a friend? That should be. Your mother is your first paddy. Mm-hmm. It doesn't mean you don't respect her, but you have times a mother, if your mother and you're watching me, learn to come down to your child's level at certain times so that you can speak the same language with your child for your child to understand. To be a mother is not a position. To be mm-hmm. a father is not a position. It's a responsibility. Mm-hmm. So don't run it as a position. And I'm your mother, so whatever I say, you should know. Sometimes calm down and speak the same level, share jokes, play together, and then in the course, sometimes watch TV programs together. I always say that it's difficult to go through sex education with your children, mm-hmm. but when watching programs together, mm-hmm. you take advantage. Mm-hmm. Like somebody is kissing somebody, you don't say, hey, don't watch. The moment you do that, you are drawing the child's attention to mm-hmm. some. Why is mm-hmm. mom saying I shouldn't watch? But you take advantage and explain why they are doing that, what mm-hmm. it means, why she shouldn't do it at the age she finds herself. Because these days we watch movies, you see people doing it and they are feeling high, dancing, and you know, we look at uh-huh. their moves. Mm-hmm. Hey, this guy can dance, so mm-hmm. but we saw the person doing something mm-hmm. after. Especially when it comes to movies that you see people killing others. You know that they are drinking something, then you take advantage and explain. Which we shouldn't joke. The church should also get in. The church shouldn't pretend it's not happening. They are with us. Mm-hmm. We fellowship with them after church.
They are gone. The guys are gone.
These
the ladies
days,
are gone.
What is happening is Sunday, I don't know the name they call it, but right from church to the joint, they won't even go home and change. You observe what I'm saying. Okay. So Sunday between 10 and in the evening, see a lot of people at joint. From morning service to the joint, from second service to the joint. Mm-hmm. What were the discussions that they feel taking pleasure there?
Who is checking that? You see, that
nobody
is
cares.
That is
all no, that no, we no, want no, you no, to. Nobody, that's, you see, are that, church, and you, we've
because
closed.
Of somebody will say because of our background.
That's why we pay attention
exactly,
to all those
but
things.
Our mothers or our parents or whoever is watching might think that it's the norm of the day, and let's allow our kids. For instance, you're talking about parents being a friend to their wards. They leave home as early as 5:30 a.m. Everything has been done on the table. They come home very tired.
So sometimes drop the funeral, go out to them.
It's so.
Go to that joint with your child, especially the teenage. See what they would like to drink.
I think that see, is that
see
is something
the
we
friends.
Need to.
Sometimes, mommy, I want to go out. Can I join you? Invite your friends. We're going to somewhere. If I'm permitted, I can give an example, like maybe a Brie Gardens, Legon Gardens. So bring your friends.
Let's go.
I'm like, yeah, invite your friends. I want us to spend some. Get to know the kind of friends your children are moving with. Because addiction, the basis for it, apart from the biological with genes and those things, is strive with peers.
Yeah, exactly. That is
community.
Most, exactly. Exactly.
I'm handling a case, the person is, the person wants to stop, but his problem is where I live. Where I live is there. Even if I don't have money, I will have somebody who buy for me. It's true. When you go to the bar, I always say that is what I'm expecting in the church, but it's not happening there, but in the joint.
Yeah.
Go and sit there idle for 5 minutes.
Somebody
you get somebody who can, ah, why are you here? Look, can I join you? Master, bring this. You are not even ready to buy it, but you get somebody who buy it for you. So if you are already tasting it, why wouldn't you enjoy? And they buy it for themselves. So they know today you don't have our sponsor. The next day I don't have your sponsor. Those selling also have become a family with them. Even if they don't have, they will serve them. They will get money and come and pay. This is the community we are running. And everywhere you find blue kiosks and those, you know.
So now.
And they know themselves. The way
definitely,
they
definitely.
So I asked somebody, so how would you know I popo? And then when I look at your body, you don't do my body.
How?
Are you sure?
How?
So madam, the way you are fresh, it means. So I asked. So it means you just say and say to Chemi, you know. So he knows the danger, but I don't know where I can't stop because when I as I'm going back, I'm going to them. That is what we eat. That's what we brush our teeth with. You see the environment.
So Justy, let me come in, Tina. So now the body is accepting the body now, the tolerance now, it is increasing by day now.
It's increasing because your body has tolerated.
Exactly.
Levels.
So now we move so from the tolerance straight to then that person is addicted. And that is the danger. That is where the person, probably the parent will get to know that
become dependent.
Exactly.
You won't know.
No. Sir, when they are addicted, now they can't hide it again.
Who told you?
I'm telling you.
All that you say is, "Hey, me ben and say you fear you mama," you know, or that do or did do.
So,
but do we look for?
No, we don't look for the cause of the sleeping, too much sleeping.
Now they want to watch TV alone. They are on their phones. You get it. Some of the girls, when they are receiving calls, like they want to enter into the walls.
Yeah, so,
why so?
So the worst the worst push them to the walls. And it's whenever they have the when I'm ever dealing with my young adults, they laugh. You see, whenever they get the call, the way they will be.
They tell you the trend of the conversation.
Yeah, exactly. Then, especially when the parents are around. Okay, all right.
This is all that you hear.
So, okay, Mate, bye. And you ask yourself, what is the other person saying? You know,
and that's okay.
And the parent probably still might be ignorant. So, with your caller, this is how you speak. But there's always something beneath what our younger adults are doing.
Exactly.
Now they are addicted. They are addicted to masturbation, lesbianism, pornography, whatever. And you ask yourself, they'll come to you, those of us who they know, they'll come to you also for this. But why shouldn't parents rush them to hospital, but rather churches, but rather they should seek something else? So now, after this question, probably we'll draw the thin line between it being spiritual or it being psychological, because now we are establishing the fact that if
they are both,
but now, and you'll be there, you'll be, but you are doing your own self because
but you think you see it's a defense mechanism, a way of denying that I don't want to, but somebody, you know,
that's what I'm saying. So that we shouldn't rush those.
So if somebody is doing you to do some,
So what should we do? What should we do the person some? How should we go about it? What should we do?
One, identify and accept that this is what I'm doing.
So the first thing is to accept. Okay, now I'm
identify
smoking.
I'm
masturbating.
It's not helping me.
Okay.
I'm masturbating. I am a sex addict. I'm a porn addict. I am social media addicts. These are things you don't think is addiction.
Yeah.
But I don't see why you buy credit and you make somebody rich. Because what are the things you are watching on social media bringing to you?
So, sometimes
5 minutes like, laughter.
You feel fine.
Because the information you get, you can't use it to make anything. You see? So now you have to accept that this is what I've been doing and it's not helping me. So once you are able to accept this, then you ask yourself, how do I help myself? Can somebody help me? Can I talk to somebody?
Okay.
Then you make a move. I need to talk to somebody. Who are you talking to?
Okay.
It's not a pastor.
Okay.
There's nothing wrong talking to your pastor.
No, it's not a pastor who doesn't have a background in counseling psychologists.
Not necessarily.
There's a pastor who
anybody who is ready to listen to you.
Okay, that's it. No, okay, that's the point. Okay.
But the issue, the person should be able to direct you to the right resource. This is where I have issue with the church making it look so spiritual. Because I said all these four comes together and make us whole. So, know if you are a man of God, a church worker, know your limits, know what you can help. You see, sometimes the way we approach it even aggravate the situation. And if you had your be and yes, I didn't be Christian, you see, you are judging the person, so the person will go back and won't come again. But you, the one who is listening. If you don't have any positive solution, just listen and tell the person, can we seek further help than to judge the person? Already the person with addiction is struggling with the guilt. That is why they are hiding. Because I'm guilty of something that is causing harm to me and I'm still doing it. How would people think? How would... So you topping it up with, in a Christian, now you say, master for the intercept, you know, doesn't help. So you rather push the person for further studies. If you think you don't have immediately, tell the person that, okay, I'll get back to you. Then look for the right resource. This is where the challenge is.
That's where some pastors wouldn't do.
But I'll pray for you. Then fast.
I
am not against that. But the point is, it is a biopsychosocial spiritual.
Okay.
Don't treat one and leave the rest. It won't work. You get it.
You touch on
because there's the medical aspect where you are administered medication. It doesn't mean don't pray.
The prayer support, like malaria, when somebody is sick.
Exactly. When somebody is admitted because the person is with malaria, I don't think any pastor stops the person from taking the healthcare procedure. But we still pray.
Okay.
It's the same with addiction. Addiction is the disease with the brain.
Psychological. Okay.
You see, the dopamine levels have its natural way of
regulating. What is that?
It's a chemical in the...
What can say dopamine level?
It's a chemical in the brain that makes, tells the brain how to respond to issues. So if you are angry, the dopamine tries to let it get you angry or make you cool. It regulates. So it's a chemical in there. And then with the neurons, it works with the neurons. So it pushes the neurons, you touch a fire and it runs, communicate to the neurons, take your hand and then. But it's very swift and fast. So it's something. So it's a chemical in there. Simply, it's a chemical in the brain. So naturally, that's the way it regulates itself with the neurons. The way we do things. But you have used something to retune it, which is not easy to bring it back. I must be sincere, it's not easy to get out of addiction. But you have retuned. So going back means you have a lot of work to do. This is the, where we don't have the patience. So it takes time. Note that it didn't take just a day for you to become that addict, be it alcoholic, drug, activity. It didn't take you a day to enjoy telenovela.
It took one series from the habitual, the tolerance, and now you're addicted to that. Okay.
So it will definitely take time to reverse it. That is where I want everybody to get to. So if you're a parent and your child is an addict and you want the child, it's not about shouting. It's not about going back to sleep and wake up and he's okay. One of the myths is that a relapse means failure. No. It's part of it.
Exactly.
It's so in a kind, I said, oh, tough for man.
I'm sorry.
You don't sleep there. No. You wake up. Sometimes you don't even clean. Then you move on.
Yeah, exactly.
And I said, car, the Ushua. Does that mean it's not a car mobile?
No, you're sitting
there. Same with addiction.
Exactly. Exactly.
So when relapse come in, it doesn't mean the person has failed. So you say, you see, sometimes how we treat them worsen the situation. But see the person as human. I always say that wangasa oshem rama onwa, you are not able to go by. You flop. But because I won't, you know,
you are the one.
Intimate partner, my say, then you move on. The same with addiction. It's the same.
All right. So, so just what we have concluded is this. I'm not saying addiction is a psycho or spiritual, but addiction shouldn't be. We shouldn't rush an addict to the church house to pray for, give him 40 days of fasting and prayers. Thinking that after that the addiction go. I interviewed one man here. He said also for when I finish praying, it's when I smoke to the apex because after praying, nothing moves me again. What comes in mind is the craving for me to smoke, and I did smoke. It was God who saved him one day, and he began pulling off from the drugs that he was doing for 19 years.
The save moment was at a point in time
when he realized that no, this thing must stop.
Realized something happened.
Exactly. Yeah, there was definitely. I'm summarizing.
I know someone. I think he started doing it secretly and also for bah. So he has after school he goes there, do it and come back. And so one day he was going there. And then there was a police, what's the name they give to it? They have an operation to arrest those. So he was fast to see. So he just went and then just by the wall. So the police bypassed him and arrested almost all those who were. He was yet to enter the ghetto since then.
That's all.
So. What I'm saying is something happened.
Yeah.
Back to biopsychosocial, spiritual. We will say that God intervened. Yes, it's true. But after the incident, those who were arrested even got back to it.
Okay.
So what went through his mind?
He
had time to analyze the situation, asked himself questions. If I were to be arrested, how would it be? Where would my education have ended? And all those stuff. So you are your thoughts back to psyche, the psychological side. So upon putting all these together, he was able to tell himself that for this reason, I won't be there again.
Thank you so much.
Have you been there? Are you telling yourself? Will you tell yourself?
Yeah, that's wonderful.
So it's not somebody is doing you. You do the prayers, but if you don't act your bit.
Exactly. That is the point. That is the point I want her to base on so that I will tell you guys that my time is up, or our time is up for us to leave the studios. Whoever is watching, addiction is not a day product. It began from continuous become habitual to that, and the body started tolerating whatever you've introduced to the system, and it become dependency on it, that if you don't take it you can leave, and that craving will come into the standard and say, you are dying already. But when you become addicted to any other thing, for you to stop, there's no rushing into the church for you to be prayed for. But as parents and friends and loved ones are praying for you, you also need to take that step and tell yourself that, yes, indeed, I'm not going to do it again. And parents, please, we shouldn't expect a changeover at night. It takes time because it's a development of the system. We need also to reverse just the same way they were addicted to something. It took time. So letting go of addiction also takes time. Let's have time for them. Let's love them. Let's pamper them. Let's get them together to ourselves. Let's love them for them to know that indeed we care for them. Because Christ told the woman, go and sin no more. We also need to passionately let them know that they should go and don't do it again. But with support, and let's also take care of ourselves. This program has been on your airwaves since last 2 years, and we are thanking God for you and for me and for my guests who always comes and sit down to educate us one way or the other and share testimonies or experiences with what they have gone through. We want to touch a heart, want to touch a soul, want to help all of us so that we can also be a para counselors or something of that sort to also educate and counsel other friends first aid, that we can also move them to the next stage. The program is Wounds of the Heart. Today I was blessed with Justina Ujiri. She's my body, you know, and she was here to help us. She has been here before, and she'll always be here whenever the time comes for her to stay. Justina, God bless you for your time. Whenever we call you, you make time to come and share with us what you know about any topic that is given to you. God bless you, and we pray that whatever you're asking God to do for you, He should do for you, so that we will share the testimony here. God bless you, Justina. And God bless you, the viewer out there, for sticking and staying with us throughout the program. And whoever is ready to change, God should help you change for the better. I've been your regular host. Thanks to Slick Africa. Thanks to Alpha Art. Thanks to you out there. Next week, Wednesday, you're going to meet with another wonderful topic. Until then, I've been your regular host, Pastor Daniel Abedu Bidiaba. I'm out.